ですね is a statement plus affirmative, so isn't, so it is, isn't it? Alright, so いいお天気ですね is good weather, it is a good weather, isn't it?Is what it is. It's a good weather, isn't it? いいお天気ですね。いいお天気ですね。Alright. So now, what else? 明日は曇りです。明日は曇りです。明日は曇りです。Now,For those who are actually seeing this, you might want to actually, like on YouTube, you might want to actually stop the video so they can actually write it down. 明日は曇りです。Alright? 明日は曇りです。明日は曇りです。I mean, you can actually see the pronunciation, the third one from the top. Let's read it. 明日は曇りです。曇りです。Alright? So what's 明日?Tomorrow, 曇り cloudy, this, statement. What's the subject here?
明日は。
So tomorrow is the subject. 曇りです cloudy is. So tomorrow is cloudy. Okay, sounds great. Next one.
彼は学校へ行きます。彼は学校へ行きます。彼は学校へ行きます。彼は学校へ行きます。
彼は学校へ行きます。
Now, what's 彼?
It's not これ, it's 彼。彼 is he, right? He.
So, 彼 is he, 彼は makes a subject.
So it's he, not him, not his,
but he,
because wa is a subject specifier.
What's 学校? This is 学校. Now, double consonant is a small tsu, so 学校. What's 学校?
School.
What about school?Particle here. A is a particle for
to.
Right? So, go to school. Right? 学校へ. Right?
行きます. 行きます is
to go. Yes. So, he goes to school. He goes to school.
He goes to school. 彼は学校へ行きます.彼は学校へ行きます。
OK。なあ、あそこの大きな木を見てください。The next statement。
あそこの大きな木を見てください。大きな means big. I just wanted to throw you some new words so it doesn't get too boring. But the structure is the same.
あそこの、あそこ、what's あそこ?大きな木を見てください。What's あそこ?
Over there. 大きな means, right next to it says, 大きな means big.
Okay, so big.
木。木を見てください。木を見てください。What's 木?
Tree, right?
見てください means, please look.
見てください
means,
見てください means please look.
So, 大きな木。
大きな means big. 木 is tree. Wo is a particle for direct object.
So, あそこの大きな木を見てください。
Over there, please look at the big tree over there. Please look at the big tree over there.
あそこの大きな木を見てください。Do you see it?
Okay. Well, then, let's write it down the phrase underneath.